pranams to the lotus feet of Mata Amrutanandamayi and also my pranams to each and every one of you who assembled here. I feel so happy to be here for 50 minutes plus 10 minutes. 50 plus 10 minutes. Always I used to say our ultimate aim should be learning and teaching. Swadhyaya pravachanabhyam na pramaditavyam. Never deviate from learning and teaching. There were 114 civilizations on the surface of the globe earth, of which 112 got wiped out. Only Indian culture plus a little bit of Chinese culture remain now on the surface of the globe earth. 650 years of foreign invasion from Middle East country, 252 years of foreign invasion from Europe and beyond that did not kill India because of Indian cultural, Indian scientific, Indian social, Indian psychological and Indian spiritual values. Integrated Indian knowledge existed in India for the last not less than 10,000 years, right from BC 8275, according to archaeological evidence, right from BC 8275 up to 2017, 10,000 years divided by 20 or 21 is equal to 500 generations. India remained intact, and today morning I was fortunate, or I felt happy, to read one very big title. By 2018 January 1st, less than five more days, India will be one among the five economically top nation in the world, crossing England and Germany. That is the title. Overtaking England and Germany, India will become. Yesterday's newspaper, for the first time India got invitation to be one among the member of the 20 most developed countries in the world. India will be participating in that. So remember that our India, with the 10,000 years of history from the back, becoming one among the five top economically rich nation, and definitely going to guide the world as American president and Japan emperor said, we, who are this we? America, India, Japan, Australia, we will be guiding the world from hereafter. So we will, that is the greatness of India. So I am very sure that you know the future of India, future of the world. Majority of you might have heard 10 avatars of Mahavishnu. Have you heard?
Yes.
10 avatara, Malsya, Kurma, Varahascha, Narasimhoda, Vamana, Parasurama, Sri Rama, Sri Krishna, Balarama, Kalki, social media, iti ekadesha. 11th should be social media. utilize social media to conquer 746.5 crore people in the world. 746.5 crore people in the world, you can conquer them using your WhatsApp, your YouTube, your face page, your Facebook, Twitter, and never stop till the last breath. When I was invited here, he said, arise, awake, stop not till the goal is achieved. Real meaning of that Kathopanishad, you know, Uttishtada, gloriously stand up. Uttishtada means gloriously stand up. Jagrata, be aware that you are not permanent in this world. Prapyavaranibodada, enlighten yourself by acquiring knowledge from the scholars. Enlighten yourself by acquiring knowledge from the scholars. Integrate the past with the present and the future. Integrate the science and spirituality. Integrate the good from the old and good from the new. Integrate the good values from wheresoever they are available. And march forward. Never stop. Never say, I am weak. Never say, I will try. Never say, it is impossible. It will be possible. March forward without stopping anywhere. Just like Swami Vivekananda said, set your goal and work for that. Set your goal and work for that. If one among 13 children in a fisherman family, one among 13 children in a fisherman family could become a Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam and become President of India, you can also become one of the greatest. If a tea seller can become Prime Minister of India, you can also reach nearer to that. I am sure about it. If Dr. C.V. Raman can get Nobel Prize for doing experiment with an equipment purchased for 189 rupees, an equipment purchased for 189 rupees, he could discover Raman effect and could get a Nobel Prize. If the great grandson of a Kenyan cook can become American president, great grandson of a Kenyan cook, Obama, could become American president, you can also become anything if you have got a will. Ichha Shakti in the mind, Jnana Shakti in the brain, Kriya Shakti in the body. Ichha Shakti in the mind, Jnana Shakti in the brain, Kriya Shakti in the body. When you are learning the modern subject, world nowadays, people are looking for Indian heritage. 3 months back, I was fortunate enough to visit the eighth time America. America has changed violently, externally violent change, internally silent change. They started looking to India or getting deeper knowledge and greater knowledge. Many people are there in the world to take our knowledge. Very few are there to give the knowledge. Many people are there to take the knowledge from India. You know, last month, one procession organized in Moscow, by ISKCON. The length of the procession was 6 kilometers. In Moscow, remember that, the capital of the communist world, and world is changing. They are looking to India. Bharatam, Bhava രാഗ താളം ഭാരതം. They are looking to India. Four subject you have to learn. Four important subject, printed notes are given to you. So one subject, Indian literature. First subject, Indian heritage literature. We have got 2000 foundation literature in India. Christians have got only one, Muslims one, other country people one, but India 2000 foundation literature in Sanskrit, 10,000 commentaries in Sanskrit, 1,00,000 sub commentaries in 22 Indian languages. That is we can call as Indian heritage literature. 2000 plus 10,000 plus 1,00,000, written by thousands of rishis, including thousands of subjects and thousands of book for the last many thousands of years. So 2000 plus 10,000 plus 1,00,000 ancient Indian literature gives you all the knowledge the world is looking for. Remember, thousands of literature written by thousands of rishis, by including thousands of subject for the last many thousands of years. Second subject you have to learn, customs and rituals of India. That is the world looking for nowadays. I was fortunate enough to take my 7th postgraduate degree MBA from IIT campus Bombay last 2 years back, and 28 students were from Denmark and Europe, 25 people from India. They were all asking the question about Indian customs and rituals. My mentor was Dr. Y.L.N. Murthy from Harvard University, who has taken his PhD in Bhagavad Gita from Harvard University, Dr. Y.L.N. Murthy. So remember that he was also asking questions about Bhagavad Gita. Almost Bhagavad Gita is by heart to me. So remember that world is looking not Indian nuclear weapon, world is looking not Indian curries and food, Indian knowledge, ancient Indian knowledge. When you stretch your hand on either side, 180 degree in front of you, that 180 degree is the modern knowledge developed during the last one century and a half, 150 years. The knowledge developed during the last 150 years in front of you. Behind you, there is a 180 degree. Behind you, there is another 180 degree, the knowledge accumulated in the 114 civilizations existed in the world. Remember, as I told you in the first, out of 114 civilizations, 112 civilizations got wiped out. Only two remains now. From that, you belong to one of the most richest culture of the world. So first, learn little bit, at least little bit about literature. Second, Indian customs and rituals. Classify Indian customs and rituals which are good for mind, good for body, good for building family relation, good for cultural enrichment, good for social bondage, and good for national integration. Indian culture, Indian customs and rituals meant for enriching our mind, converting a weak body into healthy body, and enriching our family relation, father, mother, son, daughter, brothers, enriching the family relation. And the customs and rituals meant for enriching our cultural values, social bondage, and national integration. Classify the customs and rituals under 6 head, then learn. So first learn Indian literature. Actually, I am sure you are very young students. Where to learn, sir, all these things? we are interested in learning the Indian literature. From where you can get, I assure you that the knowledge is in your pocket. Knowledge is in your pocket. Just switch on your mobile phone, go to Google search, just give Chanakya's Arthashastra, full detail you will get in your pocket. If you want to know Bhartrihari's Upadesha Shataka, even spelling of Bhartrihari you need not have to know. So just give Bhartrihari's Upadesha Shataka. Management principle in Ramayana, just give, you will get it in your pocket. Only thing at the time of driving the car or scooter, don't listen to that. Keep it aside. Otherwise, any subject is available. Just search Google research, our Takshashila University or Nalanda University or Pandya Vamsha Temple, Civil Engineering of Tamil Nadu temples, or Khajuraho Temple, or you want to know about Amarnath, just give in Google search. Just want to know what are the changes taking place in Kedarnath, give Kedarnath, you will be getting everything. So it's not at all difficult for you to learn Indian literature. It is not at all difficult to learn Indian customs and rituals. The third point, first Indian literature, second Indian customs and rituals, third Indian spirituality. Nowhere in the world it is there. You know Shivalinga, one Shivalinga, you might have seen that 449 atomic reactors are there in the world. 449 atomic reactors. All the 449 atomic reactors are exactly like Shivalinga. Exactly, no other form can be created. And why Shivalinga has got that structure? Just go to your Google search, Wikimapia, and find out Mount Kailash. Shivalinga is the miniature form of Mount Kailash. And Discovery Channel, people, they investigated what is the importance of Mount Kailash. They could see that from Mount Kailash towards west up to Iraq, from Mount Kailash towards north up to Mongolia, from Mount Kailash towards east up to Singapore, from Mount Kailash towards south up to Mauritius, the climatic conditions are controlled by Mount Kailash. This is what they could find out. Discovery Channel could find out. My request to you, Indian spirituality, when we say Lord Brahma has got four head, there is a science behind that. X-axis, Y-axis, Z-axis, and time-axis. Four axes in Lord Brahma for creation. And his wife arbitrarily fixed as Goddess Saraswati, the knowledge axis. And Mahavishnu, blue color for the sky, which has got infinity, and also the color of the sea. Our Brahma, Vishnu, Maheshwara, all scientifically arbitrarily fixed, like Professor Fridtjof Capra, professor from Berkeley University, and who is nominated for the Nobel Prize, one among the 11 people for theoretical physics. He said all Indian concept could be created by the laboratory which is present from within. Your mind is working as the laboratory. So learn Indian literature, learn about Indian customs and rituals, learn about Indian spirituality. Then the fourth subject, as I told you, four subjects are there. Fourth subject. All the modern subject you take, then put the word heritage. Heritage biotechnology, heritage mathematics, heritage physics, and heritage chemistry. You can see thousands and thousands of books, and also really demonstrative thing in front of you. You just see, if you come to Trivandrum, you can definitely see Padmanabha Swami temple, the gopuram of Padmanabha Swami temple, the top of that 97 ton weighing single granite stone is kept, and in front of three Padmanabha Swami 970 ton weighing single granite is fixed. It is brought from 16 kilometers away Tirumala. How could they move 970 ton weighing single granite, carving it and fixing there during a period when there was no electricity, no diesel, no petrol, no coal, no chisel, no electric equipment? They could do that one. You can see the granite, marvelous observation. Granite musical pillar, 1000 pillar in 8 temples in South India, they could carve out during a period when there was no quick fix and fevicol. There was no quick fix and fevicol, they could carve it out of that. You put your ear in first pillar, hit the second pillar, Saptaswara, from which sa you can listen from that. So Saptaswara pillars, not 1000 pillar in one temple, like that 8 temples, like that 8 temples, civil engineering marvel. If you come to Thiruvananthapuram and see the gopuram of Padmanabha Swami temple, only on March 21st and September 21st you can see the sun gliding down for setting through the 5 windows of the gopuram. Only 2 days in a year, March 21st and September 21st. No other day you can see sun gliding through that window down. So astronomical parameters connected with the civil engineering marvel. The shadow of that gopuram will never touch the earth. Another marvelous thing. Like that we have got hundreds and thousands of gopurams. Go to Kanyakumari, you can see Kumbakonam, Suchindram and Chidambaram temples and the gopurams which they could construct while where LHS is equal to RHS. What is LHS? Left hand side is the mirror image of RHS, and not even a single crack anywhere in any spot. Remember that almost 1880, the first ship full of Portland cement came to India. First ship full of Portland cement came to India. These gopurams were made 700, 800, 1100 years ago. And not using Portland cement, still remaining intact. Whatever is made using modern cement almost got out after 120 years at the maximum. So our civil engineering marvel, just to think about it, whatever subject you want to know, go to Google search Kumbakonam temple, Sujindram temple, or Kanyakumari temple, or give, you can see everything. Rameswaram temple, that gopuram and the hall and other thing, it will be something beyond the level of imagination India could do. And the second point, just iron pillar of Delhi, even though Lalu Prasad Yadav is staying nearby, that it has not rusted. So remember that rustless iron pillar, 32 pounds of iron pillar, that circular thing forged, welded and created 7 ton weighing 21 feet height iron pillar of Delhi. How could they do forged welding during a period of BC 50, 2067 years ago? They could do forged welding during a period when there was no electricity for heating, no coal for heating, no petrol or diesel for heating. They could bring the temperature of iron up to 1130.